Hey everybody, it's Stacy with Spectrum, the other clinic. Today I'm going to be doing a subcutaneous injection, but a couple of things to note before I get started. Number one, I know this isn't an alcohol wipe, but I needed it big so that y'all could see it. I need all my supplies to be big for visualization. This needle that I'm going to use is not anywhere close to what a subcutaneous needle looks like. This is very thick and long. It is only for demonstration purposes so that y'all can see what I'm doing, because if you couldn't see the needle, which you likely wouldn't be able to with a subcutaneous needle on this crappy camera I have, then the technique would be a little bit lost. Also, this is a vial of testosterone that I have borrowed from someone. I will not be drawing the medication out of it. I will just draw air because I don't want to ruin their supply of tea. So anyways, this is also going to be my little fake skin for injecting. So let's see, without further ado, I'm going to stand up and you're going to focus on the equipment here, and we're going to go over the steps for a subcutaneous injection. Alrighty. So then we've got all of our equipment, we've got our medication, we've got our alcohol wipe, we've got ourself here with the skin, and then we've got our needle slash syringe. First thing to do is whatever your dose is that you're going to be pulling out of your medication vial, you need to have that same amount of air pulled up in your syringe. So let's just pretend for visualization's sake that my dose is 1 milliliter. So I'm going to pull up 1 milliliter of air into my little syringe, and that is to put into here so that whenever I pull out the medication, the air goes in ahead of it and it doesn't mess up the vacuum that's inside of this vial. You can get some pretty nasty surprises with getting sprayed with medicine over time if you don't practice this technique and put air in first before you withdraw. Anyway, so I've got my air drawn up. Next, I'm going to make sure that this is sterilized on the top. So I take my little alcohol wipe and I'm going to wipe in a circular fashion for 10 seconds across the top to make sure it is sterile. Don't want to be putting any bacteria into our vial. Then I'm going to take the same alcohol wipe, get my site that I have chosen, I'm going to wipe it and sterilize it in a circular fashion for about 10 seconds as well. Then I'll set my little alcohol wipe to the side. Alrighty. So now then, I've got my syringe with my air in it, I've got my vial, I'm ready to go, right? So make sure you are holding this on a firm surface whenever you are operating your needle and everything. You don't want to be doing this number. People think they're so special. You will end up poking yourself eventually, no matter how good you are with your hands. Anywho's, so I'm going to take the top off the needle, and see, that is quite a large needle whenever you look at it. That is not what a subcutaneous needle looks like at all. But again, you need to be able to see this. So putting this on a firm surface, such as a table, and holding it between my fingers, I'm going to take this, place it at a 90 degree angle in the direct center top of the vial, and push down to access the vial. Now is when you can release your hold on the table here. Flip it upside down and inject the air into the vial. You're then going to withdraw your medication, which mine will be air because I'm not going to steal their tea. So I pull out the exact same amount of medication that I put in of air, flip it up, and pull out. Alrighty, I'm going to set the medicine over here to the side. So we already cleaned our site off, we've got our medicine, we're ready to go. Take your two fingers and spread them about 2 or 3 inches apart and put them on the site and just kind of secure the skin there surrounding the site. I know some people like to pinch up a piece. You can, you don't absolutely have to. I am a pincher. If I'm given an injection, I like to pinch up a piece just to make sure I have that good piece of fat. Anyways, so I've got my piece of fat pinched, got my needle. We're going to go in at a 45 degree angle, if you can see that. 45 degree angle instead of a 90 degree angle, which is what you use for an intramuscular injection. So pinch up your fat, 45 degree angle, and you go in about a half an inch into the fat. Bloop! All right, so what do you do now? You release this hand. You're going to secure the end of the needle here. Reach up. Slowly inject the medication. Done. Pull out. Ta-da! Grab your little alcohol wipe, apply pressure for about 30 seconds or more, depending on if you're a big bleeder or not. And then you can apply a little Band-Aid or whatever you want to do. to dispose of a needle. You can either purchase your own sharps container, or you can use a gallon milk jug or a 2-liter bottle, a Coke or something like that. Just make sure if you use a milk jug or a Coke bottle that you do label it for what it's being used for, so someone doesn't come along and just throw it in regular trash or anything like that. Now, I'm going to walk back through these steps in real time just to give you another view of it. Got all my supplies and everything. So, number one, pull me up some air. 1 milliliter is my dose right now. Then I'm going to clean everything. Clean the top, circular fashion, 10 seconds. Clean my sight, circular fashion, 10 seconds. Alrighty. Next then, got my syringe full of air, got my medication. Take the top off. Secure the medicine on a hard surface. 90-degree angle in the center, go down, pick up, flip. And you're going to inject the air into the vial and withdraw your medication, which mine is air. Then you flip up, pull out. Set my medicine to the side. 2 fingers, grasp. I like to pinch. Then set your needle at a 45-degree angle and insert about 1/2 inch into the fat. Let go. Grab the bottom of the syringe, move this hand up, and slowly inject your medication. When you're done, you can grasp, move your hand, pull out, get your alcohol pad, apply pressure for 30 seconds or so, and then apply a Band-Aid. Ta-da! Hope everybody learned something. You know, everybody's going to have a little bit different technique. Doesn't mean necessarily that you're wrong, as long as you're not, I don't know, spitting on your top of your medicine or sticking the needle in your eye. Other than that, you're probably going to do pretty all right. If you have any questions at all about anything that you saw here, please let me know. As I said, everyone's a little bit different. You might have seen it done differently, or you might have questions on how to draw up, what's normal doses, or anything to do with HRT. Just let me know. I love answering them, and I will see y'all later. Bye.